get near dawn. When nights grow a tired eyes, I'll soon be with you, my love. Give you my dawn surprise.
Alright y'all, this is an update, and right when I start the video, the dog starts barking again, but I got the stalker and out, leaf springs just hanging down, I got the 9-inch just chilling here, and I'm about to get the cow tracks out. The only thing I'm actually going to use for this mock-up is the bottom plate. The U-bolts, the plates, I forget what these are called, but I'm going to mock these up. I do plan on getting mono leafs. The only thing I'm really doing right this second currently is mocking it up. The factory C10 rear end leaf spring perches match up perfectly with the 9-inch perches, but the 9-inch is exactly 10 inches narrower than the factory rear end. So I'm gonna get it on, and then I got my wheels here that I'm gonna test fit and make sure everything fits, mainly so I can send the wheels off to powder to match the fronts. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the 9-inch rear end in. I'm gonna get everything basically bolted up like it's gonna be in the truck and tightened down, set it down, see what it looks like with the wheels on it. I've been waiting on this for a long time, so should be pretty cool. The plan after that is to pull the 9-inch back out, get it all cleaned up, clean the center section, the chunk, and get it ready to go back in. I'll probably like plan on pulling the rear end and doing all the work to it in like 1 week and just leave the thing on jack stand so I don't actually have to put that rear end back in and do a bunch of dumb stuff. So the rear end will probably stay in until I get mono leafs, which are about $500, so that's really not too bad. But that's the only thing I need to basically install the cow tracks, but for now it's just going to be a mock-up.
I've been waiting so long to be where I'm going. Sunshine of your love.
All right, y'all, this is why we mock up. So, I got the wrong cow tracks. I thought I specified for foot kit. This specific rear end has the spring perches on the bottom, like it's bolt-in type deal. This bracket here is made to go underneath the stock rear end in place of that block there. That's for a factory flip style. So what I have won't exactly work. That's okay. I'm gonna go online and take a peek and see what I can find. I might call Calvert Racing and see what they say. I'm sure they have exactly what I need. Another thing is the perch won't actually go around the bolt, so I'm gonna throw the Dremel on it tomorrow. And what I'll probably do for now is just bolt back up with this, because either way the rear end will still work like side to side. That's really all I'm mocking up. The only thing I was gonna try was this stuff, and I'm actually really glad I did. So now I know what I gotta do, and I'll still be able to mock it up, but all I gotta do now is Dremel that hole out and we'll be able to move on. But I probably will not get to that stuff until tomorrow because it's pretty late. Friday night going in. So That's pretty much it for now. Just a little update. About to do some research. I know I sounded a little upset in that last clip, but I'm happy, really. The spring perches do line up perfect. I didn't have to modify any of that. That's exactly how they came out of my Nova. So, really sitting here looking at it, I'm excited for the truck to have a 9-inch, and I really couldn't be happier with everything I got going so far. So, all I gotta do is Dremel those holes out. I'll be able to set it down onto the leaf springs, flush all the way. And like I said, I'm just gonna toss that bracket back on and get this bitch on the ground. I can't wait to see it. I'll pull the wheels out real quick. Here they are. They're just old school weld drag lights. This is actually the outside. Or they were the outside when I got the wheels. They came off like a 1980 Camaro. And the guy got a new wheel combo on there, but there's like a, probably like a 5-inch backspace. I can't remember exactly what it is, but what I'm planning on doing is plugging this dowel stem hole and using them this way. And I can't see anywhere where it says you can't flip them around, so I read about it a little bit. Some people said they didn't have any issues, or really everybody said they didn't have any issues. I mean, everything is pretty much exactly the same. It looks like literally the only difference is the backs have this little divot spot, and I don't know what that's for exactly. I guess I'll look that up. But they're 12 wides, so if there's 4-inch backspace, there's 8 obviously out this way. And these wheels are small Chevy, obviously, from the Camaro, and small Ford, and the rear end, that's small Ford too. So I'll throw one on real quick. I got some pretty big tires on there, 295 65s. At the time, they were kind of like all I had, and I didn't want to put street tires on them. Really, I mean, like, literally, these were all I had. I would have even put like a 275 60 street tire on there if I had them, but that's what I had. They're exceptionally taller, probably like 2 inches, but I mean, they look really good on the 12 wides. So I'll get them on the truck and we'll check clearance real quick. All right, this is stupid. It's difficult to do. The rear end is obviously not bolted to the leaf springs yet, so it's not like I can really jack the rear end up to it and stuff, so I'm getting a little ahead of myself. I know the tire's on there backwards, but it's all good. I kind of just wanted to do this. Looks like it's going to be pretty good. So, obviously they'll clear back here. I really wanted like a... from when I like measured this stuff to even think if it would work when I had all this just random stuff laying around, I measured and I could actually run like a 13 wide wheel. I don't exactly know how big of a wheel you can run with a small tire. It seems kind of like 12's the limit. I don't know. I could be wrong, but I think it's going to look good. Especially with them powder coated black to match the fronts. I got the same lug nuts. Kind of hard to see. Lug nuts and center caps. So, anyways. That's pretty much it for tonight. I'm ready to go in. So, I tried to bolt that up, but I'm just going to have to Dremel it and connect it, and it's only 8:45, but I don't feel like firing up the air and doing all that, so whatever. I'm going in and I'll start fresh tomorrow. What's up, y'all? Plan for the time right this second. It's Easter Sunday. I just got home. I'm planning on going ahead and doing the Dremel work on these real quick. I got my little compressor hooked up. Thing's cute. Got some shit to clean up. No big deal. Probably gonna do that. My buddy's about to be here. We'll slide that other rear end out. I wanna get this bitch on the ground. We'll see how it goes. What the hell are you doing,
bro? Repping.
Looks like a damn mess.
It is right now.
Does this thing come with the blue gaskets on it?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. Those are the good ones.
I know.
Did the
new ones? I was like, for like, probably didn't even need to replace them.
Are the new ones blue?
What?
Well, pizza just got here. 8:40 Sunday night, and I got the 9-inch in. It's been like an hour since I stopped the time lapse. I've been looking at it, hanging out. Had a buddy come by, a couple of buddies. So yeah, that's it. Then it looks good. I want to put the bed on like now. I want to see it. It's coming soon.